This is the way you save money. Really, go with the lowest earning month. Use that as a baseline. You're only as good as your lowest earning month. You're only as successful as your lowest earning month. Vigor Steve here with some money talk. Some of you guys asked on the previous Vigor's Q&A for me to dive a little bit more into business, money, earning, spending, that kind of stuff. So here we are. Let's give it a try. Let's see if there's a demand for it. Like, share, subscribe, all of the good stuff. Let's start with earning money, right? Unless you're a trust fund baby and you were gifted a ton of money, you don't really have to work. Most of us have to work to earn money. You can't make money. The government can make money. And as we see nowadays, inflation, well, off the scale. So you can't make money, but you can earn it. There's three kinds of currencies. There's gold, which is the currency of God. There's fiat currency, money, which is the currency of the government, right? They can print money. They can make it. And then the overall value and the denomination and the inflation really kicks you in your butt. And then the last currency out there, made by the people, cryptocurrency, right? We'll start talking about that when we get to the spending part. Most of us have to earn money to spend money. So let's start there. How to earn money, right? First of all, you need to acquire a skill that nobody else has. Ideally, a skill that you can get very, very good at, and also a skill that you really, really enjoy. So we can take myself as an example. I'm very skilled when it comes to performance enhancing drugs, how to use them safely. When it comes to bodybuilding, the nutrition, the training, the supplementation, the blood work analysis, everything that I discuss on this YouTube channel, I don't have so much competition. So I'm very skilled in this particular avenue. And since there's a lot of people who are interested in this subject, I can actively share this on YouTube and do self-promotion with every single video. I mean, let's be honest, every video is an opportunity for me to show skills, and hopefully you use one of my services, right? So I can earn some money. Besides the AdSense, I have affiliates. That's entirely up to you whether you use my discount code or not. I've personalized advice by email. If you have a particular issue that you suffer from and you can't afford the consultations, then I have a cheaper option, personalized advice by email, right? I reply within 24 hours. Consultations always needs a little bit of scheduling depending on the time zone and the place that you find yourself in. I have ebooks for sale, right? I might do a YouTube membership option beyond the current membership options that I have available. I have a ton of revenue streams, and hopefully this will inspire you to do something similar. Acquire a skill that very little people on this planet have, a skill that you really find enjoyable to follow and get knowledgeable on, because it's going to take a long, long time before you're better and more skilled, more knowledgeable than everybody else. It might take a decade. It might take 25 years before you have a skill for you to be a high ticket earner. Now, if you don't want to acquire a skill that long, right, you can go to university and acquire a skill that way. You get a nice fat piece of paper that proves that you have a particular set of skills for you to have leverage when you start looking for a job. Finding a job right now that's good earning might be a little bit more difficult unless you already have 10, 20, 30 years of experience on this particular field. So if you're just getting started, you just graduated and you have just a piece of paper in your but no work experience in this particular field, good luck. Yeah, good luck. It's not easy to find a job, or you're going to find something that is just paying you very low amount of salary, and then you have to deal with the taxes, so you get even less. If you're a high ticket earner, right, you've had a lot of experience already. So I'm talking about selling yachts, for example, or very expensive condominiums or real estate, right? Those are high ticket earners. Those people earn a lot of money based on commission on whatever they're selling. But those positions are not easy to come by, and you need a lot of experience to get into that field. Now, depending on the high ticket sales, of course, rich people are always going to be rich. They're going to be maybe a little bit less rich depending on the economy and how that is fluctuating over the years. But most people who can buy super yachts can always buy super yachts. So if you do high ticket sales, you always have a source of income. And even then, most of those positions also come with their whole set of issues. Trust me, I do consultations with these kind of guys all the freaking time, right? They're on TRT and then a little bit of advice, but they're simply too busy to do their own research. So long story short, if you want to earn well, it's going to be very difficult earning well for an employer, right? You have to do something by yourself and take the risk to be your own employer or start a business or something along those lines, right? You can be a one-person business. You can be a business with multiple employees. But if you're an employee, in many cases, you know, the financial incentive simply isn't there. I used to be a financial business consultant. I worked my way up to a very nice salary. But now being self-employed, being here on YouTube, I can tell you that that salary that I used to earn, which I thought was very, very good as a business consultant, and now I can make in a day. Yeah, I can make that in a day. And it only took 15 years to make the difference from a one-month salary into a day salary. So you really have to be self-sufficient and find something that you really love. Because if you're working for somebody else, by the time you finish your work, at the end of the day, you're going to be tired. But if you're working for yourself, you're basically always working, always learning, always finding means to earn more. And you're doing this all of your own time. So if you don't follow anything that you know, actively have a passion for, you're really not going to enjoy yourself. But if you follow your passions, even though you're always working, you always have an interest to progress and proceed and get better, get more knowledgeable, and work your way up to this top of the pyramid where nobody else is, right? You have to be the smartest in the field that you find yourself in and you have a passion for. Might take years, but you have to find the perseverance to really go for it. So that's the earning part. It's reasonably straightforward. You just have to put in the work and get resourceful. Regarding the spending parts, that's where everybody varies, right? Some people like to spend a lot of money on useless stuff. I see it around me all the time. You don't have to buy particular watches or supercars or nice Gucci bags. You can also put this in investments that I actually appreciate and don't really require a lot of management in order for you to liquidate it. I'm talking about cryptocurrencies, stocks, you know, other assets which are easily to flip. And if you feel that flipping houses is easy for you, please, by all means, it's your money. You can invest it the way you want to. What I would recommend to everybody out there, don't go cheap on your health, whether that's pharmaceutical performance enhancing drugs or blood work, or high quality foods, or making sure that you have deep tissue massage therapy, right? I don't go cheap on anything that revolves around my body and my health, but I can't go cheap on clothes. I mean, I can't remember the last time I didn't buy anything that was on a discount. I'm gonna be brutally honest. I mean, this thing, right? I have five of them. I bought from AliExpress, like $2 each. Best money I ever spent. Doesn't have to be branded stuff, right? It's entirely up to you and what network you find yourself into, because some networks really like that branded stuff. And then you have to ask yourself, if I buy particular branded stuff, will I get a return on investment? And that's how you have to look into every expense every time you spend money. Is it worth the return of investment? When it comes to your health, the return of investment is great because hopefully we live to, let's say, 90 years to 100 years old. And that will kind of pay for itself, right? The longer you focus on your health, the more money you can earn and the longer you have to actually spend that. But when it comes to supercars or watches or branded clothes, it's only required if you find yourself in a network where that's actually appreciated. So if you're still in a network where people are, let's say, middle class, for example, you can show off, but it's not going to mean anything for you to get into the next class where you start networking with people that are higher earners than middle class and then give you opportunities, open doors for you to earn more. And you can do something as simple as going to master classes or find your way into particular cigar lounges where businesses are discussed. You don't need to walk in there with a supercar. You can simply go with a nice cigar and a nice drink and start talking business, right? So again, I'm going a little bit all over the place. I'm just speaking my mind here. What I need you to understand is that expenses need to be there as an investment, right? And if you have a return of investment, a reason to make a big purchase, then I can totally see where you're doing it. But until that time comes, you don't have to. You can put this into something that is appreciating over time. Again, if that's stocks or cryptocurrency or bonds or real estate, right? That's entirely up to you. And you can flip watches and license plates and supercars as well. But that's only if you're in that network of people that can actually purchase that from you after you hold on to it for a couple months or years, or you have limited edition watches or supercars, right? It's your responsibility to get knowledgeable on investments. And until you have some disposable income that you can actually use for investments, focus your money into avenues which are important to you. Again, that's health, right? Common lifestyle expenses. But again, you can save a lot of money on most of the expenses that you have Netflix, you don't have to pay for. You can simply download it. Most of the clothes you can buy on discount. You can actually buy a lot of stuff on discount, as long as it's not food, because it's usually close to the expiration date. So find a couple avenues where you don't go cheap, and find a lot of avenues where you can't go cheap, because it doesn't set you back, whether that's on your reputation or your overall health, or for things that are also important to life, right? You can ease back on a lot of expenses and save some of that money for appreciating assets as an investment. What I found to be very, very beneficial, and I've been doing this for the last couple of years, I mentioned this on the Vigorous Q&A, starting every month at zero. So throughout the month, I get multiple transfers, whether that's cryptocurrency, bank transfers, Wise, Payoneer, Veeam, whatever else, PayPal, obviously, even though they take way too much of my earnings, right? Their fees are exorbitantly high, disgustingly high, but still, it's the best and most convenient way to earn money with the products and services that I have for sale. Same as Stripe, right? Using credit cards. Those fees are quite expensive, but sometimes you don't have another choice. So I get multiple revenue and multiple deposits and transfers in every day, basically. And then at the end of the month, I go through my financials. I pay all of my staff, right? My wife, her brother, her mom, my timestamps guy, my thumbnails guy, my editor, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Everybody that I have on staff actively, I pay at the end of the month to make sure that they're taken care of. I look at my financials. Did I cover all of my credit card expenses for my food, my house, utility bills, and that kind of stuff, right? Insurance. Cover everything at the end of the month. Whatever I have left, that is disposable income that I don't need to spend at the first couple of days on blood work or whatever else, I put it into assets. I start the month, every month, at zero. So the first couple of days of the month, sweating buckets. So I'm highly motivated from the first of the month until the couple of days that I need for me to feel a little bit more financially secure based on the revenue streams and the deposits that I get into my bank account or my cryptocurrency payments or whatever else. It takes a couple of days. And throughout these first couple of days of the month, highly, highly motivated to earn more. Then I keep this momentum going for the rest of the month. But I'll be honest, sometimes the last couple of months when I hit particular financial targets, I kind of throw in the towel and start playing video games because I felt that I'm satisfied with the amount of money that I made towards the end of the month. Sometimes during July, August, for example, where everybody's on holiday, or during January or the Christmas, New Year's time, you see that income starts to come down. Why? Because a lot of people during these times, July, August, and let's say around the New Year, Christmas time, or the beginning of the year, when people are still collecting money to kind of survive after all of the Christmas expenses, during this time, people don't really care about fitness or bodybuilding or using performance enhancing drugs. They're thinking about going on holiday and spending some high quality time with their family. So if you're just starting out in the fitness industry or any endeavor that revolves around products and services that are highly susceptible to holiday periods, expect a little bit of loss of revenue, right? You have to be ready for this based on the expensing patterns that you currently have. So you can only spend as much as your lowest month, right? And even then you should save a little bit of money. So if you're only earning, let's say $2,000 during July and August periods, because everybody's on holiday, these are now your maximum earnings that you have as a foundation throughout all of the months of the entire year for you to pay all of your bills with and all of your minimal lifestyle expenses. If you earn more, if you earn over that on the other month, so you have the lowest month out of the year, let's say that's July or August, for example, and you earn $2,000, you spend $2,000 every month throughout the entire year, but the other months, you might earn more. This surplus over $2,000, let's say that's $6,000 other months, you have $4,000 to put away as savings or appreciating assets. This is the way you save money. Really, go with the lowest earning month. Use that as a baseline. You're only as good as your lowest earning month. You're only as successful as your lowest earning month out of the year. At the end of the year, when you do your financials and you combine the entire year together, you might be earning more than $25,000 per year, right? Just as using this $2,000 as your lowest earning month, you might earn $100,000. So you have $76,000 that you can save. You don't have to live and spend according to your highest earning month. You spend and live according to your lowest earning month. Again, this is only applicable for the guys who are currently self-employed or they got a couple extra revenue streams alongside their main revenue stream, which is, you know, where they're employed at. If you got, you know, some extra work, then of course, again, put it away. You don't need it right now. You're only as good and as successful as your lowest earning month. Whether that's in July, August, December, January, that's entirely up to you. You need to manage your financials. Mine go back 25 years, and I can see clear patterns, you know, based on how people spend their money because they go on holiday or, you know, they want to spend time with their family because I'm in the service industry. I see the views go down during these particular periods. I see requests for personal services go down. I see requests for ebooks go down. Everything goes down. And then you start to sweat buckets a little bit like, man, am I doing something wrong? No. It's not you. Everybody's on holiday doing something else. By September, it will pick up. Good thing for me is that my entire year is based on my lowest earning month. I don't spend any more than I would otherwise earn in July and August. And even though my revenue streams are going up every single year with a certain percentage that is my business, not yours, right? To quote Robert Kiyosaki, mind your own business. That's the guy that wrote Rich Dad Poor Dad. Go give it a read or listen to the audiobook. It will literally change your life to the point you're now so jaded and ruined that you can't even buy anything anymore unless it's appreciating. Yeah. Now, I wish I never read that book, but at least it allows me for financial security later on in life. And I will tell you straight up, after reading that book or a couple other books, if you're not finding yourself into a situation where you have multiple millions saved in appreciating assets, it's very hard to spend money on something that's very enjoyable. So I didn't start buying anything that was for fun, I would say, like my cats or the motorbike, until I was at a certain financial position. And again, that's my business, not yours. Now, what I will say, even at your lowest earning month, you still need to start at zero the next month because you need to stay motivated. You need to put all of that money away. So even if you're breaking even, and let's say you have $2,000 worth of spendings and you only earn $2,000, you're literally at net zero. If you earned an extra dollar during that month, that dollar goes away into a savings account or an appreciating asset. Start, I can't emphasize that enough, just start at zero so you can stay motivated. Set a couple of financial targets for yourself that you should attain throughout that month. Again, very difficult to do if you're employed and you're only reliant on a single salary and you don't have any extra revenue streams to kind of top that off and collect a little bit more money along the way. But if you're self-employed and you're earning by yourself, you can set targets, you know, for celebrations, for example, at $1,000 as an example, right? So the first $1,000 that you make, maybe it takes a couple days. Okay, now you have a little bit of extra money to spend to take your girlfriend or wife out to dinner, right? I achieved this financial milestone and I'm going to use 1% or an X percentage of this financial accomplishment to take you out to dinner, right? That's a simple rule you can have with your wife. I did this many years ago. When I make X amount, we're going to dinner for X amount. Now, this could be 1%, 0.5%, or maybe 5%, depending on the financial milestone that you want to reach within a certain amount of days that the month has started. Let's say that's $1,000. For 1% of that, $10, you can't really do much with your wife unless it's like going for a cup of coffee and maybe having some cake alongside of it that you probably have to share, again, because of inflation. So if you earn $10,000, you take 1% of that, that's $100, right? Now you can start looking into having a nice romantic dinner, perhaps with a glass of wine or two alongside of it. If you don't think that the $100 is enough to celebrate, you might have to raise that percentage of your financial milestone that you have throughout the month to 2%, 5%, 10%, albeit that a 10% celebration might be digging into your finances that you just reached, right? If you make $1,000 and you take 10% of that, now you have $900 left, right? You still have your lifestyle expenses. You don't need to party that hard every single $1,000 that you make. So I'll leave that entirely up to you. Use the money that you just earned, a percentage of that, to kind of do something fun. And if you don't earn within your financial milestones, there's no reason to party. Really, you're not working hard enough, you're not earning enough, you're not deserving of doing something fun. I had to be that brutally honest, but you have expenses that will keep going and you need to start earning more money for you to be financially secure and successful. And there's no drinking or going out to dinner or watching movies, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera, until you are in a position to start doing that. And again, it really depends on where you live, how much taxes you need to pay, and how you know, horribly the inflation is in your country. So maybe $2,000 is enough for you to start celebrating and taking your girlfriend, wife, partner out for dinner and doing something fun. But in some countries, it might be $10,000. Yeah. Sometimes it might be more. So that's entirely up to you and which financial incentive you need before you feel comfortable to start taking somebody out and paying for all of the expenses that you have throughout that night. And it might mean that, you know, you're earning so well that you say, you know what, baby, I think after a whole month of earning, let's go away for a long weekend. I do this with my wife most of the months when I feel that we've earned enough money to kind of celebrate with a long weekend at a nice resort or a hotel. I mean, don't get me wrong. Some people prefer to grind until they're at the millionaire level. They grind and grind and grind and don't take any profits along the way. So they don't really go out. They don't go to celebrate. They don't buy any new experience to kind of take the edge off and relax a little bit. I don't believe in that. I do feel that you need to take profits along the way for experiences, but not for useless things that you basically bought on an impulse buy, right? Taking your girlfriend or wife out to dinner on holiday, trips, doing sightseeing, right? Enriching your personality with experiences. If they cost money, so be it, right? I don't believe in buying more stuff to the point your condominium or your house just starts filling up with random stuff that you don't really need. Some people prefer to live like that. But after traveling all over Asia for an entire year, living out of a backpack, which was between 15 to 17 kilos, that was all the assets that I needed. And they were all functional, mostly clothes, a laptop, a camera, and a toothbrush and some multivitamins and you know, some shaving equipment. And that was basically it. When you live bare bones for a while, you realize that you really don't need much. But when you live bare bones, all of the doors regarding experiences open up because you don't bring all of your luggage with you. You don't bring all of this baggage, all of this extra stuff that you don't really need. Now, that was my life, maybe not your life, but I can highly recommend it. And honestly, guys, if you find yourself into a position where you can actually live out of a suitcase for a couple of years, or maybe even a couple of months, that's all it takes for you to kind of change your mind when it comes to experiences versus material things, you'll realize that all of those experiences that you can get along the way are worth 10 times more than the assets you can put into your suitcase. The suitcase is just going to weigh you down. So for most of us, most of the people that I know that traveled quite a bit and became financially secure by becoming an expert in a particular field that they love doing, their suitcase is quite empty. But their experiences are very, very high. That's why they have something to talk about, a lot of things to share, a lot of things to contribute to this particular niche of knowledge that they find themselves in because they've been grinding in this particular avenue for years or decades. The assets will go away. The material objects, they will expire. You'll become bored with it. You don't want it. You know, a fire can take it away or some sort of accident. But it's the experiences that will last you a lifetime, assuming that you're investing into your health as well. So you invest into your health to last you a lifetime, and you invest in experiences which will last you a lifetime as well. And combining your health with experiences and this unique amount of knowledge that you've got yourself, you can make a significant amount of money. I promise you that. You can make a lot of money for this life that is now very long lasting, right? You cover all bases, and the material things will just come and go. They're kind of passing through the dimension that you find yourself in. So again, I hope this gives you some ideas on how to spend your money. All right, health, very important. Experiences, very important. And everything else that you earn over that, that you don't need for health or experiences, put it into something that appreciates. All right, and do your research, because not everything that appreciates might appreciate as well as other things. When you start comparing a cryptocurrency to the stock exchange or gold or some of the other things that you can invest in, Bitcoin and cryptocurrency kind of outperforms all of them, but it also comes with a ton of risk. And you need to be very strong-headed and level-headed for you to make the accurate and smart investment choices. So you don't start investing when the market is already up. You start investing when the market is very, very low and everybody starts to panic. Maybe you need to read one of those books about investments first. Really hope this helps you guys. I know it was kind of all over the place. If you want to know something specific about financials, just let me know down below in the comment section. I will gladly address it if there's a demand for it. And otherwise, Well, we'll just stick to performance enhancing drugs and how to use them safely. Thank you guys so much for watching. For now, we're out of time. You can find everything that I'm associated with down below in the YouTube description section. Follow me on Instagram and TikTok at VigorSteve. Vigorous crew, you guys know to do a front double bicep for you guys. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.